Hello, good morning, you two.
Hello.
So,
look who's joined us.
Look who's joined us.
Yay!
It's Sue.
Sue's back.
She's back for
I'm pacing forward.
Yeah. She's going to do the final third of the Pembrokeshire Coastal Path. How are you feeling about that, Sue?
I'm feeling pretty good about that, especially when you told me it was on a bus route. And I've got my bus pass with me, in case.
Lovely, lovely. How was your journey from Whitstable?
It was pretty good, because I'd been very busy before setting off. So even though there were difficulties online, and there were 2 hour delays, it was lovely to have the rest and to be greeted at the other end by two charming young men.
Okay, nice. That's us, Howard.
Always positive, Sue.
Absolutely. Was the old smithy like last night where we stayed?
Absolutely full of ducks. Ornaments, ducks, and more ducks.
Yeah.
And we had a terrific breakfast this morning.
Yeah.
Couldn't fault any of it. It was perfect.
And what about the company last night, Hal? How was that?
Terrific company. We met two Americans and who were walking, or are walking, the coastal path the opposite direction to us. And they were lovely, weren't they, Sue?
Steph and Laz, who was a veterinary surgeon, and she was in banking.
Yeah.
And they really were a terrific company.
It was really nice to spend the evening just chatting and drinking and eating.
We did drink.
Yeah, we did. We did.
Well, that's what this is going to be about, isn't it? Isn't the aim of this to drink and eat a lot?
I think so. I hope so.
What is your expectation of the Pembrokeshire Coastal Path, Sue?
Beautiful beaches. Various coloured sands, because that's what I recall from over 30 years ago. Black sand, white sand. So I'm looking forward to the adventure.
How about you, Hal? What's it like to have Sue join us now?
Fantastic. We've been looking forward to you coming. It's really good. I'm loving the coordinated outfit. You probably can't see there, but if you scan down, you would see the matching coral socks, which I think were possibly purchased for this trip, along with the matching earrings. There we go.
You're looking like Lana Turner.
Is that a compliment?
Yeah.
I'll have to ask somebody a bit older.
We're entering the firing range now, because it's August, and for most of August you can get through the firing range. So we're in Merrion, where we stayed last night, and we're now heading straight down there, straight to the coast.
So I am here with, I don't know her name, I've just picked her up en route. We started off with Sue, she disappeared, and we found this sort hiding amongst the bushes. Who are you?
I'm sorry, I can't tell.
How do you feel about wearing that hat now?
Like film star.
Which one?
I'm thinking Virginia McKenna in Born Free.
Yes, I've got the leopard skin thing.
Have you filmed the back?
Yeah, we've got the back.
Yeah.
Yeah. Maybe Virginia McKenna, Born Free. Yeah. Were you born free?
Yes.
We are back on the coastal path now, after being made to walk around it because of Ministry of Defence land. We've now been allowed to walk through it, because it's their day off, and we're now back onto the Pembrokeshire Coastal Path. And it's your first time on it now.
It is.
Feeling good about that?
Yes, I am.
Okay, that was just a little bit of an hors d'oeuvre.
An intro.
Really. An intro.
Mm-hmm.
Here we go then, Pembrokeshire Coastal Path with Sue.
Good luck, Sue.
Thank you, Howard. Put the specs on now.
All those autograph hunters.
Quick, Mark, let's make a quick getaway. I love the rip. rock formation, and I just wished a geology person was here to explain it.
Yeah, that's what we've been feeling the whole way around. So, what's the going underfoot like?
It's easy going because it's grassy. There is a tarmac road we could take as well. It's flat and we have beautiful views to our right. And we have the army fields to our left with the odd tank here and there.
But it's quite flat, isn't it?
Very flat.
Yeah.
And the rugged coastal side.
How do you feel, Sue? Are you okay? Because we're quite close to them. Oh, Sue, my God, there's one with horns there. I'm freaking out. Sue, how do you feel? How do you feel, Sue?
Get the face. The face says it all.
Huh? Sue, this one's looking at you. Sue, how do you feel?
Yeah, yeah, one is.
You're joking.
Just don't look round. Oh my God.
Honestly, Mark.
Yeah, honestly. I've got the set piece.
I've got two of them coming quickly.
Honestly, Howard.
No.
You great fibbers.
Poor cow.
I'll get my own back on you.
Poor cow.
You better keep looking over your shoulders.
That was Mark, Sue. Mark was encouraging me to do that.
Me.
I don't like a chiro moment at all, Sue.
You don't.
I don't like it. I get very nervous.
I thought you were.
Here we are on MOD land, and there's a tank there. And we're not allowed to come off the coastal path while we're on MOD land. I'm desperate to go and sit on the tank, but Howard's told me I'm not allowed. Sue, who was really moany doing this circle, said that she called me BB. A new nickname, BB. And I said, what's that? And what is it? It's quite a disparaging nickname, isn't it?
Big body.
Bollock brain is what she called me.
And I don't believe a word Mark and Howard say anymore.
Why?
Because they said we were on the bus route. And we're not. No signs of houses, villages or anything. We're still in the MOD district. And we don't know where we're going.
Would you say you're being a little bit like whingy?
No. Would you?
Yeah.
We need to go and look at St. Govan's Church here. Yeah.
Well, you might be.
Yeah.
You can come back and tell me what it's like.
See what I mean, Hal? Obstinate. Have you ever been called obstinate before?
No, never.
How do you feel about being called obstinate?
Quite like it.
Wow. Would you look at this? A chapel carved into the cliffs here. How old is this?
I don't know.
Wow, look at that view I just see. Impressive stuff, really. Well, here we are at our first bay on this morning's walk. What do you think, Sue? What are your impressions?
I can't wait to get down there and dip my toes in the water.
It's lovely, eh?
Yes,
Actually, like Howard said, that's more people than we've seen.
Yes.
But it's still loads of space.
Loads of space. Plenty of room for us.
Yeah. Come on, let's get... We are here on Broadhaven South, and it is the most populated beach so far on the Pembrokeshire Coastal Path. There's still loads of space and it's delightful with families having fun, but it's the most populated. Did you have a nice rest on the beach, Sue?
Yes, thanks. Very patient you are, you two.
Did you enjoy your cup of tea?
Oh, not half. Wonderful. Well, I didn't know you were filming me.
An ice cream?
Oh, that was great. Delicious, creamy ice cream with chunks of honeycomb in. But it was the tea. Delicious.
So we finished the walk today at Broadhaven Sands and we will pick it up again tomorrow from here, but we're off now, a little detour to the lily ponds, which we're looking forward to immensely, aren't
we? We certainly are, especially a cup of tea.
Rumour has it there may be an otter or two to see. We'll see.
Or homemade cakes.
Where are you off to?
Well, we're going to the lily pads. Where are you going, Howard?
I'm going to the lily ponds.
Well, I'll follow you because they may be near each other. All right?
We are in the middle of this fantastic wood now on our way to Stackpole Village and the Stackpole Inn, having left the lily ponds, and it's magnificent. It just doesn't look like Britain. Well, we've completed our 9-mile hike to the Stackpole Inn in Stackpole Village, but the Pembrokeshire Coastal Path is 2 miles back there. What did you think of the whole day, Sue? She's glamming herself up for her public.
Well, I thought it was a lovely day. We've had excellent weather. Sorry about this, but we've just arrived a bit disheveled. Yeah. And we were so fortunate. We've had a beautiful scenery. And lovely company, doesn't he?
Always.
Mostly.
Yeah, he gets a bit tricky, doesn't he? Yeah.
And of course, a drink at the end of it.
What did you think of the actual scenery, the walk today?
Breathtaking, because all the shots of the sea and the lovely rock formation and the arches in the rocks and the beautiful colour of the sea. And the last beach we went to, lots of families playing.
Cheers, Sue.
Charles.
Bottoms up, as they say.
You're in very good health, Howard.